All right, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another one of our Hack the Box challenges. Here today, we are going to be taking a look at the Optimum box. All right, this is another Windows operating system. Hey, y'all, if you like love these series, these challenges, please do me a favor and smash the like button. If there's a particular box that you want us to try and pop, you want a walkthrough of it or maybe a write-up, just leave it in the comment section and we'll try to get that to you. All right, so let's dive right into it. Once again, we will not be using Metasploit here. I'm sure you can use Metasploit to do this, but we won't be using it here. So the first things first, situational awareness, you all. This Windows pane down here is using Python 2. Okay, this Windows pane is using Python 2, all right? I have it set up in using a virtual environment. So the first thing we're gonna do here, obviously, is gonna be our nmap scans, right? And there are a bunch of them that I usually run. I don't know if I've ever showed you all of them. This is most of them. I may add some to this. Okay, but this version scan here shows us that we have port 80 open and it's using a file server, right? We get the version number, the service, the port it's running on. And if you actually browse to the IP address or to the web servers, you will see this. Okay, I'm just using this domain name, but you will see the same thing here. All right, this is a file server, right? This is a file server that's being hosted, a file server using HTTP. All right, this is allowing us to store files over the web, okay, or port 80. Now, some of you may be familiar with this from Try Hack Me. I know I was. This is why it made this box a little bit more easier for me. But this version of this file server here is vulnerable to, I mean, a few things. One of the vulnerabilities here is that the file server doesn't handle null bytes pretty well. Right, there's an exploit out there that abuses the way this file server handles null bytes, and it essentially it's putting a command, or it's executing commands on this box after a bunch of null bytes, I think. Right, but this server here is vulnerable, right? The way it handles the null bytes, it allows us to execute some code that responds back to our listener. So you've probably already done your Google searches by now. You maybe or maybe not didn't have found the exploit, but if we just do a search exploit on HFS 2.3, you will see a bunch of these here. Feel free to go through them one by one just to get familiar with these exploits and to go through your trial of error of getting them wrong, right? Or just reading and failing. Eventually you'll come down to this exploit here, the 39161. Okay, I should already have that. And I do, I have it here. Now the way this exploit works, it is a Python script. The way this exploit works, it's gonna take the script, then the argument will be the target's IP address of this guy here, and the port number that this system is, that service is running on. In addition to that, we're gonna have to host a web server that has netcat stored within it. Okay, because what the script is gonna do is going to copy our netcat file and use it to execute some commands to connect back to our listening shell. Okay, so let's look at that. So we're gonna need that script 391, our target IP, the port number. Now we're gonna need to host a web server so this script can reach back to. And within that directory of the web server, you need to have this executable here, netcat.exe. If you don't know where to get it, it should be under Windows binaries. User, share, Windows binaries. And here it is. So just copy it over to wherever you want to run this web server from. And the web server has to be running on port 80. So Python 3, whoops. Gotta sudo that. All right, so we have our web server listening now. One more thing we have to do is open up a port on 443. And that's because in this script, it's listening on that port. Obviously, you could change it. You'd have to change your IP address as well to get this to work. Sorry, I should have mentioned that. You could change this port if you want to. I just left it the same. Now I'm going to go ahead and execute this. So Python, the name of the script, our target IP, and the port it is listening on. You may have to run this once or twice to get it to work. I know I did the first time. I had to run it twice. But that's okay. So here we are. We got a shell back as Costa. The first flag is here on his desktop. All right, the first flag is right there. So from here, I'm gonna fast forward, not take you through all of the steps that I did. But what I did try to do was a bunch of manual enumeration. All right, I tried to check for special privileges. I was looking for vulnerable configuration files. I ran WinPs. I tried to chase the nuggets that WinPs had gave me, but none of those really worked out for me. Maybe I was just rushing. But eventually I used this exploit suggester, right? The Windows exploit suggester, which is a pretty cool tool. You're probably already familiar with it, but it is going to take the system information from this target right here. Is going to take its system information. It's going to analyze it for exploits that could possibly give us a shell or compromise that box. All right, so now to use this though, let me see. You have to get it from GitHub, Windows Exploit Suggester. Yeah, there are two of them. There's a next generation one. This isn't the one I'm using. Okay, this is the one I'm using here. So I will post this on I'll post it in the description of the video here. All right, so this Windows Exploiter, I'm gonna use it, show you how to use it actually. So I already have it here. I think that's not it. Where are you? Actually, I have it in another directory. So in order to use this, the first thing you're gonna have to do and it says it here, is update it. Right, you're gonna have to run that update switch so you can get the latest exploits and all the information it needs to start doing its scan. So we're gonna do that update. All right, and you can see that it's just gonna rewrite to this file that I already have. And the reason we have to run this update is because this script right here, it needs this file. So we're gonna go ahead. And how does this work one more time? Okay, so database, we're gonna give it this file that we just grabbed from the update command or that update switch. And then we're gonna do the system info and point it to our system info.txt. Now you're probably wondering where I got this from. So what I What I did was I ran system info on this box. And then I just copied and pasted this. I copied and pasted all of this. Everything, right? From the top over here, I copied and pasted it all the way to the bottom. And then I just pasted it in on my system over here. All right, if I just open up that, you can see it's the same thing, right? I just opened up the text file, this text file right here on my box. You can see it's right here. Okay, so we need that system info for this to work because the script is gonna correlate this Excel file with the system info to see what exploits to suggest. Right, and the only way you're gonna be able to get it is by running system info on this compromised shell and then transferring that information over here. So we're gonna go ahead and run this. I'm not doing something right. Oh, got to start with Python. So Python, the script, dash dash database, point to the Excel file, dash dash system dash info, and then point to the system info file. Is it dash system? Okay, I see what I did. There shouldn't be a dash right there. So now this is going to go ahead and start looking for some exploits that we could possibly use to pop this box. All right, I'm going to start from the top. All right, so here's the command we ran right here. Here's the first exploit. You can see this is a denial of service attack. We're not going to use that. Okay, here's another one. The next one down is the one that we actually use, MS16-098. All right, MS16-098. Oh, I have it open here, but let's look at this bulletin. Actually, here we go. So this exploit here is abusing. So there's a vulnerability in the way, and I'm explaining this in the using my own words in the best way that I can explain it. From what I know about it, I'm not a guru when it comes to these exploits. I just know how to use them, and I try to learn why and how they're working. So this right here is abusing the way that the kernel is reallocating memory. All right, that's how this exploit is able to do its buffer, well, integer overflow, because of the way memory is being reallocated. So feel free to do some more research on this. I highly advise that you do, just to get a better understanding of how it's working, why it's working. I had found a nice write-up on it. I don't want to take too much time looking for it now. So that's that, right? Fortunately, here is a repo. There are a few different repos that have an executable file that will exploit this vulnerability here, right? It will exploit the way that memory is being reallocated. So all we have to do is download this repo and then transfer this executable file to our victim box and then launch it. So that's what we're going to do. I already have the repo. I'm going to make sure you get that as well. Okay, so you're going to need the repo. That's the repo there. So I have the repo here, actually. CD Windows, and then MS 16098. So here it is, the bfill.exe. Now we have to transfer it from our attacking machine to our victim machine. This could have been done in different ways. You could have possibly used PowerShell to download this, right? PowerShell from here to download it. I'm just going to stand up an SMB server using smbserver.py. Okay, this is a Python script that is going to set up an SMB server on our attacking machine, and we'll be able to retrieve files from this SMB server using this Windows box we just popped. So, but the key here is to make sure you're running this in the same directory of the files you're trying to transfer. So we're trying to transfer that bfill.exe, so we need to run this inside of this directory. Okay, this is started. All I have to do now is copy 1010. This is my IP address. The name of my SMB server is Cali. Right, and it's running in my current directory, which is this. So what's the name of the file? bfill.exe. And now it copies it. Because I already have it here. I'm just going to override it. It's okay. If I dir this out, you will see the bfill.exe. Let's do a who am I one time. Where Costas. Let's launch the bfill.exe. Let's do another who am I. And we are now system. All right. And that's how you pop this box, escalate your privileges to you without using Metasploit. Okay, this was pretty straightforward. We got our initial foothold from this vulnerable HFS server. Right from here, we did some enumeration. Well, before we got that initial foothold, we did some enumeration here, found an exploit to receive our initial shell with. Afterwards, we did some more enumeration on the actual target. We found it was vulnerable to a bunch of different exploits, specifically MS16-098, which we use to escalate our privileges. All right, that's it for this. Hopefully you enjoyed this walkthrough. Please check out the Medium post that we have listed in the description. Right, if some of you are readers, I think you'll enjoy that as well. You all have a good one. Stay safe. Enjoy your holidays. And I'll see you next time. Peace.